Historic trends in violence can't be assessed by headlines. Headlines are about things that happen, and they give you no indication whatsoever of how common a particular activity is. Because you never see a reporter standing outside a school saying, here I am in front of Maplewood High School, which hasn't been shot up today. Or here I am in the capital of Mozambique, and there's no civil war. So forget headlines. You have to. The only way to answer the question of what are the trends in violence is to look at data, where you count the number of occurrences as a proportion of the number of opportunities, and you see whether that's changed over time. So since I wrote Better Angels of Our Nature, I sent it off to the press in end of 2010. So the data that were available were from 08, 09. I keep yearly updates on what's happened to those trends. And with the exception of civil war, which after a roller coaster downward from the end of World War II, has shown something of an uptick because of the Syrian civil war. It's wiped out about 13 years of progress, taken us back to the level of about 2000. But it's still a fraction of the level that it was at in the 60s, 70s, and 80s, when you had not just 8 or 9 civil wars going on at a time, but 25 or 30. We tend to forget them. We tend to be amnesic about all those nasty wars in Africa and Southeast Asia that were going on in the 70s and 80s. But a lot of them had a considerable death toll. So it's clearly things have gotten worse in Syria. They've gotten worse in Ukraine, in Pakistan. But the global trend has not reverse the progress that we have seen by any means. And then all the other trends, such as homicide, which kills far more people than wars, continues to go down. Sexual violence, at least in countries that have good data, have continued to go down. Rape and domestic violence, child abuse has continued to go down. More and more states and countries have abolished capital punishment. Even democratization, government, the absence of government violence, where we're aware of backsliding in countries like Venezuela and Turkey and Russia. But still the global trend continues to be that the world is getting more democratic. We don't read about the countries that have liberalized, but we hear about the countries that increase their repression, and that they do exist, but on the whole the world has become more democratic, as well as less homicidal, less gender-based violence, less child abuse, and so on. And even in the category of war, you can divide wars into wars between countries, old-fashioned wars of country A declares war on country B, and civil wars. And the first category, interstate wars, government on each side, has been in kind of sputtering decline for many decades. There are fewer and fewer wars between countries. The wars that exist are civil wars. And that record has continued to improve. Namely, we've had zero interstate wars since The Better Angels of Our Nature was published. And in fact, we've had zero interstate wars since the American invasion of Iraq in 2003. And historically, wars between countries tend to kill more people than civil wars. So even with the backsliding that we've seen in the case of civil war, in the case of the most destructive form of wars, the world has still not seen a return to the bad old days of the 70s and 80s.